Tonight in St. Louis, Missouri, something important will be decided. Which five men will represent the United States in Rio at the Olympic Games? Sam Mikulic may have a spot locked up, but behind him are nothing but maybes. At the end of tonight, though, those maybes become definites one way or another. Do they look pensive? Absolutely. It's the final night of the Olympic trials. NBC Sports presents the 2016 U.S. Olympic Trials for the sport of men's gymnastics. We're on the campus of St. Louis University in the Chaffetz Arena, and we welcome you to what should be an eventful night. You can feel the tension in the air. I'm Al Troutwig, along with my favorite gold medalists, Nastia Lukin and Tim Daggett. Andrea Joyce is also with us. Five spots, that's it, to go to Rio. And you would think maybe that the top five finishers at the end of the competition will be the five guys, but that's not the way it works. It's a little bit more complicated than that. Nastia, help us out.
So the selection committee is really looking for the team final situation. That's all that they care about in that given moment. So there's going to be a five-man team, but on each event in the team finals, only three men will compete, and all three scores are going to count. No room for error, so they need to fill all those spots.
Let's introduce you to some of the major players. He's got Hollywood looks. He comes from Southern California, was a star at the University of Michigan, and has won four straight national championships. But here at the trials, Tim, he hasn't really looked like a national champion.
No, he hasn't. But you know what? At the end of the day, even with the fall we're going to show you, look at this right here. Very nice release on the first one. And this one, you got to hold on, folks. That happens too often with Sam Mikulic. He's so good, though, he'll still go to Rio.
So Sam is in front as we welcome you here live. They're in the third rotation, and we'll pick up our coverage in a moment. Now, John Orozco grew up in an unlikely place. He grew up in the Bronx. Dad worked for the sanitation department and found a trailer in the garbage, and it led to him having a gymnastics career. How's he looking?
That's right. He had a fantastic night of competition day one, and on his first event here has looked great. So, you know, all week long here in St. Louis, he has been so focused in his quest for making that second Olympic team.
John is trying to redeem himself from some mistakes he made at the London Games. Now, another player who wants to get back to the Olympics is Danelle Leyva. Born in Cuba, raised in Miami, represented the United States at the Olympic Games. What's his status?
Well, he's a maybe. And it's not because of anything he's done thus far in St. Louis at the final trials. It all started at the beginning of the process, the national championships in Hartford a couple of weeks ago. And on his best event, where he is absolutely spectacular, this is what happened. Look at the air, huge height, but he's off the bar. But tonight he has done himself a major solid. A weakness for Team USA is the pommel horse. He survived, so he's got two hit routines here in St. Louis, which will help him tremendously. He's mid-14s on this event, which is exactly what he needed to do.
An emotional favorite for many is a 29-year-old who's given just about a full lifetime to the sport of gymnastics. He wants to get to the Olympic Games because he just missed 4 years ago as an alternate, and that really is tough to overcome emotionally. Chris Brooks at the age of 29.
Absolutely, but you know, this process, up until his first event here, he has been phenomenal. Two meets in Hartford, the first meet here in St. Louis, but as I said, pommel horse is where they struggle. See those legs come apart, bending at his hips, leg separations again. He counts on P-bars, high bar, and they wanted to depend on him on pommel horse. He put a big question mark all over his bio today with that routine.
It may have looked like a small mistake, but as we have seen, when it comes down to the Olympic Games, those add up.
Absolutely.
DB, can you throw me my
towel? I'll tell you, though, there are so many things that are going on right now, though. Danelle Wittenberg, who was a lock before we got here, he struggled immensely the first day in St. Louis. So far here, he's been phenomenal. I had thought he would have to be superhuman to get back into contention. And for him, he has been just that.
Danelle Leyva on the vault. It's got to feel great, Tim, to get that pesky old pommel horse out of the way early.
Well, he did a vault the first day, and he hasn't competed all year, and he did it great. More difficult, 2.5 twists. That was a great ball. Not as perfect as he was night one, where he stuck that cold.
It's his dad, Ina Alvarez, who has more emotion than most people.
You know, ever since Sunil walked into this arena earlier this week, he has just looked like a new person. He is so calm. He is so confident. And he said, my job is to be the guy who the selection committee says, yeah, he's on the team.
Donnell Wittenberg there. It looked like he was a major player. Then there was a feeling he might have slipped out of the picture. But tonight, he has been a major player. For more, let's go to Andrea Joyce.
Al, when you look at Donnell Wittenberg's childhood, it's no surprise that he became a gymnast. I just talked to his mom, Sheila Brown, and she insists that he was doing somersaults in the womb. And I tracked down his childhood coach, his first coach, Abdul Mamari, who remembers vividly the very first time he saw Donnell in a Baltimore area gym about 14 years ago. He told me he had never seen a kid so strong and so fearless. He called it a good kind of crazy. Well, last week, Donnell's mom sent him a video of those crazy days. And guess what? Donnell was reminded of that free spirit he had as a kid, and his mission is to recapture that. Al, props to all the moms out there who always seem to know what's best for their kid.
She wants this so bad, like any parent would. Donnell Wittenberg in a moment of deep thought. Tim, what allowed him to fall out as a lock?
Well, a lot of things. The pommel horse was an event where potentially he could be considered, but he has not shown that in any of the competitions. And then he scored extremely low on his biggest contributing event, Still Rings, which comes up next. He hasn't fallen, didn't fall here in St. Louis, but he just got really tight and really sloppy. This routine so far, much better. Little bit of a knee bend right there. And there's another tricky part. Doesn't have as much extension of his hips as the judges are looking for. But this is a hit. Oh my goodness! Not a disaster. Not a disaster, but in total, I would say that's gonna cost him a good half of a point off. I think at this point, though, with the performances that he's had, Team USA would not be using him, wouldn't be considering him for pommel horse. And so, yes, that's disappointing, and he wanted to get through this exercise. So he needed to watch his hand go here. One will go in the middle, and now he's supposed to reach to the end, which he can't get to. Comes off on the wrong side of the horse.
Well, after his first two routines, which he stuck and did well, he was pounding his chest, pounding his heart. Not so much right now. Back to Danilo Leyva. What's he going to be thinking about a 14.95 on the vault?
That's good. That's a good score for him.
So once again, we've gone with a green, yellow, and red to help you along, because even if you're a diehard, the scores are sometimes difficult to figure out, and sometimes it just comes down to deductions. And if you can minimize those, you're doing all right. So green is minimal. Yellow, you're starting to get in trouble. Red, like that one, that's no good.
Bad. And that's very disappointing for him.
Now, Sam, as we showed you, fell off the high bar and then had a very bad ending to his floor exercise.
I'll tell you what, though. I believe he's a lock, but Team USA needs this routine desperately. I mean, Sam is a lock for a lot of reasons, but I would say the biggest one is because of this event right here. He really needs to show the selection committee that he can handle the pressure here. He's capable of getting a very big score. This is tricky. A little bit of a separation. And he'll travel the horse all the way over and then come all the way back again. Very good. Not great, but very, very good.
This is starting to feel like his night one. First two apparatus, not good, and then back in the right direction.
Yeah, he's definitely been far from perfect here in St. Louis, but still, a four-time national champion. He's definitely not going to be left off of that team.
So the selection committee is made up of six individuals. On your left there, Dennis McIntyre. He's the only one that has a voice with no vote. On his right, Kevin Majaika, who is the equivalent of Marta Caroli. In the middle right there, Yoichi Tamita has a vote. And then you've got an athlete representative, David Durante, right there. Next to him, Kip Simons, an Olympian coach at Navy now. And to his right, that's Steve Butcher, who is the technical committee president for the FIG. So he holds the highest position in gymnastics at the World's Olympic Games.
So we'll be explaining what goes into creating and choosing an Olympic team for a sport like gymnastics in Rio. But what's going to happen is immediately at the end of the competition, those six men are going to go into a room, and they have 12 minutes, that's the plan, to choose and announce the five-man team. So Sam does pretty well there, a 15.2.
And that's big, though, because, you know, he has put so much doubt a lot of different places. He has struggled at these championships, but that score right there, that's one of the major reasons why, regardless, he's going to Rio. John Orozco, and this is another critical routine for him. He's capable of doing a great job on pommel horse. He did night one here, struggled in Hartford. You know, a lot of people have been talking about John Orozco, and, you know, unfortunately, he had a really rough time at the Olympics on pommel horse. Not rough, it was catastrophic. He just really didn't deal with the pressure well. I can't imagine that they would have him go up in a team final on pommel horse. This is important because he gets to show, hopefully, that, you know, mentally I'm stronger. It's not going to happen to me again. But I don't know if they'd use him anyways. But that is going to be a very good score. It's going to be in the 15s.
He is so happy with that. You know, he said, as you said, Tim, everyone keeps talking about that routine 4 years ago. But he wants to get over it.
When he's smiling, things are good for John Orozco.
Gorgeous, man. Come on,
bro. It's amazing. We were looking at the standings from the Olympic trials 4 years ago. So many of the players remain the same. Like Chris Brooks.
So remember, he started off a little rough on pommel horse, which will definitely hurt him. Once again, he's not a guy that they would use in the team finals, but he would go in the qualifying. It's a handspring, double front. Very nicely done.
No, he's done so well both a few weeks ago in Hartford and, of course, here today and the day before. And he said, even being in second place in the all-around, I could be put in an alternate position, which shows the depth of our team.
Remember the deal, if you're an alternate, you don't get the bag of swag. You don't even go to the Olympics. You wait in some other country if you're needed. John Orozco doing okay with a 14.825, but we have a lot of important gymnastics to come. It's the last night of the Olympic trials. Tonight, we'll know who's going to Rio. NBC's coverage of the 2016 U.S. Olympic Gymnastics Trials is brought to you by Samsung, proud partner of the Rio 2016 Olympic Games. By Kellogg's, proud sponsor of The Start. And by Xfinity, change the way you experience TV. Back in St. Louis, Al Troutwig, Tim Daggett, Nastia Lukin, Andrea Joyce, and Chris Brooks comes out of that vault. Tim, okay.
No, absolutely. It's a great score for him and very usable.
Now, Alex Nador, a four-time U.S. pommel horse champion, and we talk all the time, pommel horse is just really hard. And there's former gymnast Holly Weiss, Alex's wife.
And his dad is also his coach. That's Mike Nador. He's a gymnast himself. Has trained a number of athletes over his career. And like you said, Al, this is an important routine. I think that he has really made his case just about already, but a rocked out horse routine right here, in my opinion, secures a berth to Rio.
like Chris Brooks, he was an alternate for London, so we might see a lot of emotion from him.
Really nice work. Little bit of a separation. That's not going to be dramatic. This is tricky. Handles it extremely well. Has a good rhythm on pommel horse. He said, pommel horse alone doesn't make an Olympic team, but that one I think did.
Wow, look at that.
And he knows that.
Nice job.
Holly Weiss, Alex's wife, is a former gymnast as well, a world champion on the uneven bars. There she is right in the middle, and she's actually to her left. That's Chelsea Memel, a world all-around champ.
And they also were tied for the world championship on the uneven bars together in 2003.
She's relieved right now. He gets ready for the next rotation. Around the corner, we'll get his score and update things here in St. Louis. It's the U.S. Olympic Team Trials. Monday, Ninja moves to a new time, 9 Eastern, 8 Central. He was the first American to conquer Ninja Warrior. Can Jeff Britton do it again? Don't miss the new American Ninja Warrior, Monday on NBC. Back here in St. Louis, the four-time national champion, Sam McCulloch, even with a major fall off the high bar, has a 2-point lead. Now, the standings don't really matter, but they give you an indication of who is scoring well. And that is good news for Jake Dalton. Sam McCulloch right now is in front.
And you know, if I had to say, Al, I would say the person whose stock is up most is this guy right here, Alex Nador. Purely because of his 15.675 on pommel horse. That is so critical. That helps to build the team. You got to look at it as a jigsaw puzzle. You got to fill in the blanks where the team needs some help.
And this is how you see it.
Absolutely. Sam McCulloch, like I said, even with his faults, he's still on there on high bar. He might be coming off of that, but he's in the game. Alex Nador, absolutely, with that pommel horse routine. Jake Dalton has just been a complete rock thus far. They need him.
Now, Donnell Wittenberg wants to be one of those question marks. Coming up next for him is Still Rings, and we'll talk about that in a moment. Here's what you think the team is going to look like. Is he on it?
Yes, he is. Sam McCulloch, he's on the team. As is Alex Nador. And for floor vault rings, Jake Dalton and can fill in just about anywhere. Number 4, number 5, those are the big question marks. And we're seeing some crystallization. Leyva, Brooks, Orozco, Rittenberg, and Ruggieri all in there. Leyva so far, he's been doing a good job. Orozco has had a great meet today.
That is USA Gymnastics President Steve Penny. I mentioned Donnell Wittenberg, and Tim just did too. Whether he makes it or not is one of those question marks. This was night one on the Still Rings where he needs to perform well.
And this dismount, he can do much better. Shows a very big lack of control, chest down, big step. Before the end of night one, he was a lock, not anymore.
Is that what he's thinking about? Or does he have positive thoughts? We'll find out what the results are next. Tomorrow is a jam-packed day of the 2016 U.S. Olympic Trials on NBC and NBCSN, with the final day of diving and the first day of swimming from Omaha, Nebraska, featuring Olympic gold medalists Ryan Lochte and Dana Vollmer. Then it's the finals of the Women's P&G Championships right here in St. Louis. Also, don't forget the track and field trials get underway this Friday. All right, here we go, Donnell Wittenberg. Does he get a different result?
Yeah, and this is probably the most critical routine for Donnell tonight, and I'll tell you why. Because in Hartford, the first part of the selection procedure, he just put up gigantic numbers. I mean, he was in the 15.8, 15.9 range, scored a 15.95 and a 15.7. But here in St. Louis, he fell off dramatically. So what was a 6 or 7-tenth bump that he gave Team USA came down to negligible, maybe a tenth of a point. He needs to separate himself from the rest of the field on rings. He needs a huge score. Two seconds, each one of these holds. Very good so far. Nice position right there. I like it that it doesn't look extremely hard for him. And you see guys and their faces contorting. A little bit high on that, came up a little high and then settled in. Just about a tenth of a point, another tenth right there. Here's that dismount, needs a better landing. Certainly a better landing, better chest position, a small controlled step at the end.
You know, when we talked to him a few weeks ago, he said, if I can stay healthy and do my job, I feel like I'm on the Olympic team. He's healthy, but hasn't quite done his job this week.
There's a lot of talking going on over by the committee. What kind of score does he want to get out of this?
No, he wants to be above a 15-5, and I don't know if that's going to happen. I think he's going to be close. Here you go. 1-1,000, 2-1,000. And the dismount, it's one of the most difficult that anybody does. He does it with his body straight. Double layout, double twist, very hard. And just that, you know what, that step could have been only a tenth of a point. So this is going to be very interesting. The judging panel on still rings has tightened up from the first set of trials. So we'll have to see.
Now, Akash Modi, the Stanford NCAA champion. Every time you look, he's doing something good.
He's great on parallel bars, and he's also pretty darn good. He averaged over a 15 on pommel horse. When you drop his lowest score, so that's three of the four meets. In my opinion, that's what the selection committee will most likely be looking for data, not from all of the meets. They'll drop the lowest score.
But he did fall on the pommel horse night one here at the trials, so it's definitely in his mind.
Big, big dismount. Can he stick? Such a hard dismount. Almost impossible to stick. But he's been doing his job. He hit horse tonight. Big routine on parallel bars. It's just, would that be enough to get him in consideration? He'd have been in a lot better shape if he had stayed on horse night one here in St. Louis.
Well, you missed it by a tenth, Tim.
Yeah.
You'll have to settle for a 15.4.
That's good, but, you know, he absolutely was looking for at least 15.5, maybe even 15.6. Kevin Majajka is the men's coordinator. The same position that Marta Caroli holds.
And one of the things they're going to do is they've got some sort of software. Mm-hmm. And they're going to take all the scores from the nationals and these two events here, these two Olympic trial days of competition, and they're going to what? They're going to spit out the five guys who give them the best chance in Rio?
Yeah, and they'll probably do it using all four meets. And then they'll probably do it dropping each guy's lowest score. That would be what I would be asking for.
So in other words, if you had one bad routine, you could get it removed.
Absolutely.
In their mind. Akash Modi, 15.45. That's good.
He's happy with that.
Sam McCulloch. We are in the fourth of six rotations. On the still rings, the national champion.
Faltered right out of the blocks here in the second day. First day, his first two events he missed badly. And then he did what I think Sam needs to do. He needs to get a little bit mad. And he was phenomenal on the last four events, day one. So this skill right here was very questionable night one. Needs to hold it. 1-1,000, 2-1,000. better. Does this great. It's called a plunge when you're horizontal to the floor like that. Really swings nicely. Do another swinging combination right here. Watch this, right up to the handstand, just glides up there. Really great rhythm. Well, by my standards, this was much better than night one in St. Louis. And Kerr Powell.
You know, no matter how many times he falls, he is still the leader of this team and absolutely will be in Rio.
Nastia, what do you think when you see a guy do that?
That stick?
No, the whole thing up on the still rings.
I mean,
you were never up there, right?
You know, one time, to be honest, I tried to pull myself up there and I couldn't do it. So they make it look so easy. It's incredible.
This is bad. It's real bad. It's bad.
Sam told us he looks up. There's his dad. Looks up into the cheering section. And he said, my dad was saying, get pumped. We're with you after a fall.
Come on, Marv.
We talked the other night. Sam does some cupping. Helps you feel better sometimes. And he's got those dark circles on his shoulders. Okay, we're getting right down to it now. We're in the second half.
Jake Dalton has had such a great competition, both in night one and tonight on his first three events.
And this is his thing. Four times he was the best in the United States on the floor.
Really difficult. Laid out and blind landing. Pretty good. Jake is great on floor, but he was a little bit hoppy. All of his landings were a little off. Night one.
Not tonight.
Wow. So once again, where Jake is a huge contributor for Team USA is this event right here, floor exercise, also on the vault and on still rings. That was great. He's really got only one landing to stick, because this one's a rollout. Beautiful. Night one, this was perfect. Going to do a backflip, three revolutions, three twists right here. Can he get it?
Wow.
I think he is the most dependable guy on the floor.
And the selection committee might agree with that.
How about that?
If he
gets done on the floor and looks over at the selection committee and they're applauding him?
Absolutely, as they should be. Remember, it's not about placing in the top five. That doesn't matter in the all-around. What matters is, can you contribute? Do you make the puzzle magic?
Oh, okay.
And there they are.
Sam Mikulic. It's a 14.925. Doesn't sound great, but he kept the deductions to a minimum.
Thanks,
he said, it's back. It's back. And I guess he's talking about his game, or at least his confidence.
You know, but Sam Mikulic, he's going to go to Rio, and he could contend for an all-around medal. He's got to be way better, though. He cannot make mistakes. He said he was angry at himself after night one.
Still got his Michigan Wolverine bag. Hey, when the team gets to Rio, what's the competition looking like? Who's good?
Well, the Chinese and actually the Japanese are the best. And Koi Uchimura is the god of gymnastics, the greatest that ever has lived in the sport of gymnastics. So those are the two main team competitors, and Kohei is the star.
Let's see if John Orozco keeps smiling.
His body should be perfectly parallel to the floor, and that He did not hold that. He was in a position for 2 seconds, but in my book, he was moving the entire time. Same move. That one was a little bit more steady. A little bit off in that handstand. Some of this strength, by my call, has been questionable. Good, but not great. He's a cat in the air. Step on the landing. You know, it's a hit routine for John. But I don't know if they would want to use that routine in the team finals, that's for sure.
Tim, I got a tweet from someone who asked me whether it's possible if there is a guy who can score 16 on floor exercise.
Yo,
Jake Dalton is, you know, one bad toe move away from getting there.
Absolutely, and he's not just a contender to go to Rio right now. He's a contender to win a medal on floor exercise.
Come on now, let's get it. Let's go, Steve.
In the games.
Trust it, baby, let's go.
Let's go, Steve.
Come on, Steve.
That was a very big number from Jake Dalton on the floor.
Come on, Steve.
Alex Nador next on rings, and for more on him, we go to Andrea Jones.
Al, I talked to Alex after his final training session for tonight, and he remembers this, the last day of trials from 2012, like it was yesterday. He had one word for it: miserable. Back then, the guys had to wait overnight to find out if they made the team. This time around, just 12 minutes, Alex told me he will sit in the room and quietly chant his name to himself. Just this: say my name, say my name. Just talking about it, Alex's eyes welled up with tears, and he just looked at me and said, I want this bad. Al?
Well,
you know what? You know what he told me, though? He said, if I don't make it, I know I did every single thing I possibly could. No stone was unturned. In 2012, he said, I had some regrets, but this time there is no way I can have regrets because I did everything in my power.
Nador rocked it on the pommel horse with a 15.675. He tattooed London 2012 on the inside of his arm to remind him of how much that hurt not making the team.
And Alex Nador has really made himself valuable on the team, in addition to his pommel horse prowess, because of his abilities on rings and what he can do on vaulting. Picking up a little bit of swing here, kind of calms it down a bit, showing good positions. And those are definite holds. He's not moving slightly through the position. There's another one. He's frozen in that spot. Just his dismount now. And he stood up a little too quick, but that one, that's a big deal right there.
And little daughter Lila agrees.
Nice set. Good job.
And he told me also that everything I'm doing is for my family. For my wife,
on,
Holly,
Steve.
For Lila,
Let's
for
go,
my
Steve.
Dad, my mom.
Come on,
it's a gymnastics family. And he says, I want to make them all proud.
And right now, she's just nervously walking all over the place. Every time he's done, you can exhale it a little bit. So John Orozco, careful, 14.775. The performance of the night, delivered by Jake Dalton, trying to get back to the Olympic Games. And he did about as good as he can do on the floor, just missing getting to 16. And after his dismount, he looked at the men who will decide his future and said, that one was for you. Alex Nador is having a great night, scoring high on pommel horse, scoring well on still rings. We're Team USA can always use help on both of those apparatus.
Sammy goes first on vault.
And he's actually got one more important lift on the vault. He's not even going to do his last event. That's how unimportant the all-around picture is.
So Danelle Leyva in the top 10, sixth after the third rotation. But again, standings don't matter. They're just an indication as to what type of Olympic trials these guys are having.
But this standing right here is critical. I believe that the judges have not, I believe they've been overly harsh on Danelle during the trials. He's a world champion on parallel bars. He's a silver medalist at Worlds on parallel bars. At the last World Championships, he made parallel bar finals. And relative to the other guys, his scores have been a little too tight, I would say. I don't think it was an accurate portrayal of what would happen on the international stage.
Is there a reason for that, possibly?
Yeah, there's. He actually has one move that, you know, it's in this country, it's been keyed in on. It comes right at the end of his routine, and I'll point it out for you, that he doesn't do great. But the deductions that they're taking, they're being very, very strict on it, and I just, they don't do that internationally, I don't believe so.
Tian Alvarez, his dad, they are quite the team. I forget if he does it in parallel bars, but he does this rhythmic clap.
Yeah.
Every single time.
He does it loudest on high bar.
Yes.
You know, Danelle told us earlier this week that he feels 100% different than 2 weeks ago at the national championships. And you can just tell the moment he walked into this arena, he has just been so focused.
And a lot of the routines before this, he's really had to hurry there. He said, I do best when it's like, watch this, people, watch this. And that was pretty darn good. Little separation. Boy, that was short. He's supposed to show 1 second on that single rail. He looks good, though. So here is that skill. That's what they've been taking, at least 5/10 of a point off on him. Well, he needed that. He needed that at the end because that was good, but he can be a little better.
That was definitely a watch this routine, though, all the way until that stick landing at the end.
I'll tell you what, though, that one element where he does, it's called a peach basket. He goes below the bars, comes back up again, and lands on one bar. He is definitely has to show a full second hold. And if they are critical on that, he loses the entire skill.
I could swear he stared at the judges. Now, there are numerous things going on at the same time. We were focused, I believe, on John Orozco on the still rings. While that was happening, Chris Brooks was on the parallel bars. We didn't see it, so let's watch it all together right now for the first time.
And remember, this is a key routine for Chris Brooks. Pommel horse was a missed opportunity for him, but his parallel bars and high bar, he would definitely be in the team finals if he makes the squad. Very nice. Swing to a handstand there. Oh, boy. And that's the same skill that Leyva did, but he got a little bit off on it. I don't know, that's gotta be at least, it's gotta be at least a half a point. It's amazing. It's so difficult when you're taller on key bars, but he has been able to deal with a dismount right here. Double front, a little bit of a hop, and that is not a great routine for him.
You know, he was so great night one. He was so great a few weeks ago at the national championships. You have to wonder if he feels the pressure getting to him a bit.
15.175, you saw he compiled a little bit of a dangerous total in deductions, but the judges didn't penalize Danelle Leyva that time, at least not in a huge way. Leyva puts up a 15.6 on parallel bars. The discussions are coming. Danelle Leyva, yeah, trying to duck that.
Each Olympic story has its own beginning, set in motion by a defining moment that inspires a lifetime of participation.
And it's a Gabby Gold!
Do you want to get started in gymnastics? Start the journey today.
Get the gold medals ready. The Fab Five is going gold.
Here's how. Go to NBCOlympics.com/goldmap to discover the direct route to Olympic sports programs near you. Find your path with the gold map today.
Back live in St. Louis, a major fall off the high bar, but it doesn't matter to Sam McCulloch, who's got a big lead. He's the four-time American champion. But the standings don't matter. Tonight, when the competition is done, the selection committee will go into a room and come out 12 minutes later and announce who the five guys are. Danelle Leyva just had a major statement on the parallel bars. Interestingly enough, right on that very same rotation, Chris Brooks took a little bit of a hit on those parallel bars. Your status is ever-changing. It's the final night of the U.S. Olympic team trials as the men head to the fifth rotation.
Store.
He'll have to do it on parallel bars as well.
All right.
He's going to be leading. He's going to be first for all four meets. And there you see triple twist. Chest a little bit down, just the smallest of hops. But he is precariously close to possibly ensuring it. I'm telling you right now, it's already a done deal. But he would like to take all question out of us.
And not have to sit in that room being nervous, just being able to sit back and relax with that selection committee.
Let's go, Eddie. Come on now.
Such a good teammate, Believe. Sam McCulloch.
Come on, Eddie. Attack.
And they're going to give him a 15.35. He'll take that.
Eddie. Absolutely.
No, hold it back. Move if you can. Let's go, Eddie. Let's do it. Come on.
All right, as Sam is rooting on a teammate, we go over to Chris Brooks. He wants to put that parallel bars behind him.
Going into this competition, I had a chance to talk to him, and he said, if I can just hit 12 routines here, no matter what happens with the selection process, I know I've done everything that I can, and I'll be satisfied with that. But you have to think, satisfied or not, there's going to be some major disappointments.
Yeah, he has so often been overlooked time and time again. Well, he's got control of hitting this high bar routine, and it's about as important as they come. He's got floor exercise next. That doesn't really matter. His Olympic journey, in my opinion, it either endures or it ends with this high bar routine.
Now on high bar, Chris Brooks.
And he is capable. Qualified to the event finals at the last World Championships. Had a really rough routine though. Finished out of the medals. Does a bunch of elements connected together, release skills. Beautiful one-arm giant here. Nicely done. Watch this. Really good. Needs to go to a handstand there. Another big release. Here we go again. Well, regardless, Chris Brooks put it out there.
How's that for handling pressure? Tim, is that about as good as he can do that?
It absolutely is. Capped off with the perfectly stuck landing.
Baby. One more.
Let's go.
Holy shankies. That was the best cheering.
He just said it. That was the best routine of my life. That's a really good feeling when you're in your second Olympic trials and you're right on the bubble. Beautiful position and just bam, rock solid.
Now on call for team
Okay, so this is another apparatus for Alex Nadora that he can help the team out on, right?
Absolutely. And although it might not be absolutely critical, you know, this would help solidify his placement. I think he's already earned a spot. Primarily because of the pommel horse and his rings, but this is very hard. Watch, double pike. Oh, baby. He's a lock. If he's not a lock, I don't know what a lock is.
And he knows it.
He got the combination today, baby.
A hug for Dad.
And the whole selection committee is clapping and smiling.
Dad must be relieved. He may not have to agonize for that whole 12 minutes.
Yep.
Let's go, Paul.
But he will anyway, because he's going to want it to be official.
Looking at his dad right now. He's walking by us.
Now, Holly, I mentioned, was a gymnast. She didn't get a chance to go to the Olympics. She missed, just missed, and so she can really relate to how this feels for her husband, who was an alternate 4 years ago.
We have three of them in this competition, but this is tremendous. Great block, and he struggles sometimes on the landing. That is the absolute best one myself and his dad pumping his fifths has ever seen Alex do. That's joy right there. His day is done. He won't do the last event. Doesn't need to.
Thank you, Rio, baby. Let's go.
Oh, where's the Rio tattoo going?
Come on now.
On the other arm.
Yep. No, that one's not going to be on the underarm. It's going to be out.
How about that score?
Wow.
Ruggieri was on your list, Tim, on that question mark list.
Yes.
Come on.
He really hurt himself, though, with falling off of high bar, because that's a place where he can help. He's good on vaulting, a little bit crooked, and he's definitely over the line. It was good, but not as great as he can do. He was actually pretty vocal in 2012 when his name did not get called. He thought he was done a disservice. Finally made a world team in 2015. If I had to guess right now, I would say that he is probably on the outside looking in.
So no screaming from Paul Ruggieri. And now Danelle Wittenberg. So Tim, has Danelle gotten himself firmly back in the conversation or not?
No, I don't believe he has gotten himself firmly back in. He certainly helped his cause with that 14 or 15-4. But remember, I said he's looking for a number, probably 15-5 or better.
Push it. Trust it.
Now he's a bronze medalist. The most recent worlds on this event right here.
You see Paul Ruggieri in the background. The reason he wasn't screaming because he probably thought he might get a low score, and he does. 14.875.
So this is an event where many thought he could definitely factor in, but the competition has been just so great here. Sam McCulloch and Jake Dalton both just knocked it out of the park. He needs a better vault than he's done all trials process.
And it was better. It absolutely was better.
And this is interesting because he's going to do a second vault, which doesn't help the team at all. But he's trying to show that he is a legitimate medal contender on vaulting, and he is. Doesn't get as much block as he could, but it's enough. Little bit better than night one. Double front, half turn, spots the ground, and look at just the smallest little slide with that 1 foot. But a big improvement for Danell Wittenberg.
His mom with the yellow handbag, obviously. She went through so much, almost everything on her own. Raising three and finding a way to get Danell into the gym. So here comes the second vault. The first one, 15.325, pretty good.
And this one can be even higher. This is just a ridiculous vault. Let's just get that out there. I can't even believe there's only a handful of people in the world that even consider doing this, and Danell is one of them. He'll do basically a triple backflip with a full twist. Oh, wow. Wow. Oh, jeez. That's ridiculous. That is just so hard. He's had some landing problems with that in the past, but not that time.
Now Danell Lehman.
Al, if he falls off.
Here's the slapping I talked about.
So, got the whole arena going.
As I said, with Chris Brooks, he comes off the bar. My opinion, he does not go to Rio. He needs a gigantic set here. Another one. This is a big combo.
How about the tension during that routine?
Wow. Wow.
I can't move, I'm going.
Good job, Randall.
All right, dude. That's how you get yours.
You know, I really think this is the best that we have seen him, both physically, but also mentally.
You know, the crazy aspect of this, I'm sure you hear all the time, you guys, that you're being very picky, maybe now that you're an announcer, Nasia, but that little hop in a freaky world, that could be it.
It could be it. It could. Because really, I think two of these guys, two of the three from Leyva, Orozco, and Brooks have a shot of going. All three absolutely do not. It might only be one that makes it. If Danell Wittenberg can sneak in there again,
so again, what's going to happen is the competition is going to end. Then 12 minutes go on the clock. The selection committee has decided that's about how long they think it's going to take. And then we'll know the Olympic team. And Danell Lehman gets a 15.675. But there's a yellow there.
Yeah, but he starts with a 17.3. That's his maximum score. And, you know, he could have stuck that landing.
Come on!
I mean, it was a phenomenal exercise. That routine at the Olympic Games, I think that'll make the finals.
All right, whatever you guys need, I'm done. You tell me.
Well, the battle is on. spot to head to Rio for the Olympics is on the line. And from the emotion, you can see how much that matters. Sam Mikulic has a very comfortable lead. He's going to easily be the best gymnast at these Olympic trials. Look at the battle between Chris Brooks and Danelle Leyva, separated by tenths. Sometimes that happens.
I'll tell you, he has done himself a major solid with that high bar routine. I'm leaning towards him, but he needed to be better on parallel bars tonight.
There's always a but.
Yep, Leyva. Tremendous parallel bars, great high bar, and the thing that he has, he was a little better on horse.
Only five spots. Those gentlemen have a lot to discuss. We'll know the names shortly. We head to the final rotation. Among the six men, a lot of head shaking like they were in agreement about whatever they were talking about. Well, here we go. A last chance impression. Here's Chris Brooks.
I mean, can you imagine a scenario where he ends up second in the all-around? He's the only gymnast that didn't have a major miss through the entire trials process. 24 for 24 if he finishes this routine. I don't think he's a lock. He's certainly right in there. But remember, this routine on floor is not that critical.
So if he is second and he did what you said, why is he not a lock?
Because the two events, the only two events where he can contribute in that team final for an Olympic team medal. It's six different events, the top three on each event. He only does parallel bars and high bar, two events. Most of the other guys that are in consideration potentially can do an additional event. He helps on rings, but it's not dramatic enough.
But I'll tell you what, Chris Brooks, he has absolutely nothing, absolute no regrets whatsoever he should have. He did everything in his power.
People are on their feet in this arena.
Nice. Hey, I'm so proud of you, baby. So proud of you.
Many.
There is the only person from 2012 team that is not competing here, Jonathan Horton, who was trying to come back also.
Where's his teammate down in Houston as well?
Can't find the right adjective because this is so gigantic, so epic. This routine right here, he's got a couple of lower scores that he wants to throw out. Remember, I think that the selection committee will look at the top three of the four scores. This is a huge release right here. Very nice. Handling all of the difficult elements. We'll do another major release right here. Fly in the air. Travel all the way back into the middle. Just his dismount. Coming up right here. Oh my goodness. Oh my. Wow.
Well, they are just making it that much more difficult for the selection committee to pick the five men.
Yeah, they are. They are.
Oh, man.
Chris Brooks.
Hey.
14.625.
Not going to hurt him at all. Not going to hurt him at all.
Come on, finish. Good job, kid.
I'll tell you, I mean, this Leyva, Orozco, Brooks battle. Jake helps Team USA on floor exercise, on vaulting, and right here.
Is it possible that this routine matters to him as well?
It does. It does. I think he's done it. But a great routine here, I think, seals the deal for Jake Dalton. Beautiful iron cross position. Nice swinging elements. Right up, got to freeze it, 2 seconds. This is really good. All of the strength parts held for the required time. Only one of them he kind of wavered in for just a moment. Here we go, the stick. Does he get it? Oh.
No stick, but I think that he is.
I think he's going to Rio. Absolutely. Woo. If he's not, I think the selection committee is going to get it wrong.
Get it, baby. One more.
John Orozco's got to be liking the 15.45 to end his night. One thing he can't be sure of is, did he do enough? He probably did all that he could do.
Yes.
Is it enough?
Yes, he did all he could do today. Sans pommel horse, he could have been a little bit better there. But it was certainly good enough when compared to his biggest competitors, Danelle Leyva and Chris Brooks.
Nice little smile of confidence from Danelle Leyva, who's getting set to do his floor.
And he really wants to show he is a reliable guy. I don't believe that he would compete floor exercise in the team finals, so the top three out of the five for Team USA. But he wants to show that he is, you can count on him. A little bit off on that. So like I said, this is important, but yeah, I'm looking over at the selection committee.
And they're not watching.
They're not watching, exactly, because they know that this is not a deal breaker for Leyva. You know, they're casually glancing up, but they are more honed in on putting that puzzle together. Which group of guys will put that puzzle together? I'll tell you one thing, though. He came to Hartford, the first set of trials, and he had been in a major altercation. His dogs were fighting. He broke up the fight, had puncture wounds in his legs. I thought he should have foregone that and asked to petition directly to the trials. He didn't want to do that. And, you know, it seems a little anticlimactic, but you know, he can rest assured by knowing that the committee wasn't watching that routine. That routine doesn't matter. It's already been done, folks.
I think it's pretty cool that the crowd has picked up on Yin's clapping rhythm, and they do it during his performances.
What a fucking power, baby!
Oh, there's that. Hey,
you remember when you meeting together?
There's a lot of gymnastics going on that's not being seen by that group.
Come on, Paul!
Are they going to be teammates in the future? And does Jake Dalton join them?
That's lower than I thought it would be.
someone's going to be disappointed.
Crushed, actually, yeah.
Chris Brooks, at the age of 29, does he finally get his Olympic Games? And does John Orozco go back? NBC's coverage of the 2016 U.S. Olympic Gymnastics Trials is brought to you by Tide. If it's got to be clean, it's got to be Tide. By The Legend of Tarzan, in theaters July 1st. And by Citi, proud partner of Team USA, proud sponsor of Progress. Al Troutwig, Tim Daggett, Nastia Lukin, Andrea Joyce, Danelle Leyva. Was a little bit all over the place, finished out of bounds, didn't matter, the selection committee wasn't watching. 14.25, and this has been the scene now for a while. Kevin Majaika just staring at the screen. There's got to be a dilemma there.
Absolutely. And I really think it comes down to three guys. And this guy is the spoiler.
We have two routines to go, and then off goes the selection committee. Well, you know what? We're going to see if they watch Donnell Wittenberg here. That would have to be a clue, right?
It would be an indication, absolutely.
Well, Wittenberg's getting set to mount the bars.
And they're still deep in conversation.
Which is very interesting. I'm looking at Donnell and I'm looking at the committee and they are not watching. You know, he dug himself a pretty major hole.
Tell you how crazy this is. Just two nights ago, Tim Daggett, who watches more gymnastics than anybody on earth, thought that Donnell Wittenberg was a lock.
And so did the committee. So did the committee. I'm certain of that. This is an event where he certainly would compete in the team finals if he makes that squad. Dismount. Fantastic.
Well, they were watching then.
I just don't know if it was a little too little, a little too late. But he just made it infinitely more complicated with that routine.
Tim, does it really just come down to the final tense, or is there any gut to this?
There is some gut to it. And they will not just look at these trials, at the scores, the national championships, and then here the Olympic trials. They also will take a look at previous international results.
Okay, we've done a little sync job here. That's after he began his routine, and that's the selection committee.
And that is amazingly interesting. David Durante now changing his focus. You got to remember, so it's a committee. So David Durante is watching this routine. Maybe he's not on board with what the rest of the selection committee is feeling.
And as I mentioned, by the time he did his dismount, just about everybody was watching. Donnell Wittenberg gets a 15.475 on the parallel bars. What does that do? We don't know.
Yeah, what it is, it's lower than, I know it's lower than what Leyva got today, and I believe it's lower than what Brooks, or than Orozco got today as well.
All right, Tim mentioned the top two all around, top three in three different apparatus, and if Sam Mikulic gets a 15.45 here, he would have an automatic Olympic berth. So how about that? He has that major fall off the high bar, and he can still clinch it.
But it's not just that fall. It wasn't just today. It was parallel bars and high bar day one here. He had
many problems in the first set of the trials at the PNG National Championships, but that score is very doable if Sam is great.
Well, when I looked it up, I couldn't find anyone who had ever qualified since they instituted this system using this.
And this is what's so fantastic, that sequence right there, and this one. Oh my gosh! And that is a huge deduction. He hit the ground. Really, he showed somewhat support on the ground. At least 5/10 of a point. His dismount.
So even with that mistake, Tim, you have to think he's still going to Rio. He's still going to be the captain.
I don't think he gets a 15-4-5, though. But like Nastia just said, I don't think he has anything to worry about. But worry he will.
And I don't have any voice.
And that concludes the competition. And there goes the selection committee. 12 minutes from now, we'll know who the five are.
And he's very disappointed with himself. The fall on high bar, that major mistake there. He's a tremendous talent, and he could contend for a medal in the all-round, possibly even push the great Kohei. But here goes the selection committee. They will now leave the floor.
What do you think? They've done nothing but talk tonight. Do you think that they're unified with the five?
I think that they're pretty close right now. And possibly what you're going to see is some, maybe a dissenter or two who just doesn't agree, wants to focus in a little bit more.
Well, the USA Gymnastics has not done this for a while. It's been a few Olympics, right, that we've had same night selection.
Chuck was fine.
Oh, Sam Mikulak needed a 15.45. He gets a 15.375, so he does not automatically get an Olympic berth. He's going to go in that room and agonize with everyone else for the next 11 minutes and 22 seconds.
These are going to be the longest 11 minutes of all of their lives. Just waiting and hoping that they will secure a spot.
You heard what Andrea said before, that Alex Nadeau told her he's going to go in that room and just repeat, say my name, say my name, say my name.
So is that guy right there. Chris Brooks.
Good job, boys.
Danelle Leyva. Some people that were in contention. Marvin Kimball.
What's your gut feeling, Nastia? Do you think you're going to be surprised?
I hope not.
And he knows. John knows that he did his job today. He just wonders if it's going to be enough. There, Alex Nadeau. Remember that amazing vault he did? And mostly that pommel horse routine.
Well, you can tell on the face of John Orozco, he's scared. Danelle Wittenberg doesn't know what to think, I'm sure.
He told me before the trials process began, and I agreed with him, that if I just do my job, I think I've got it.
I feel bad for Steve LeGendre. When we came on the air, he spoke in tears about how his family would feel if he was able to make it to the Olympic Games. He was an alternate in 2012, and it just didn't come together for him.
Big sigh of a deep breath from John Orozco, just hoping and praying right now.
Are you ready? DJ Patrick, give me some song. Olympic trials, hand skin on board of music. 3, 2, 1, let's do this.
Well, really, remember, I think what it comes down to in that selection committee, I think that the majority of them most likely are in consensus already, but they are looking at every potential scenario. I believe they won't use all four scores. I believe they'll take and drop the lowest score for each individual from the four different competitions on each event. And they'll see which team, when they choose the three up, three count lineup for team finals, which team produces the highest score.
Tim, how many guys do you think believe they have a shot? I can think of seven. Is that pretty much it?
It's pretty much it. Maybe eight. I think that Paul Ruggieri probably still thinks he has a shot, and he very well may. I don't think he did enough here today. What really hurt him tremendously was the fall on high bar. All of these guys are amazing. And you know what's incredibly gut-wrenching is they have all dreamed of this happening. Every single one of them. They have completely dedicated their lives to this sport, put everything else on hold.
So what's happening now is that the 18 men in the competition are going to be sequestered in a room, just like the selection committee. And they'll be in there until that clock counts zero. And then the five lucky men will come out and be introduced to the crowd as Team USA for the 2016 Olympic Games in Rio.
You know what, though? 18 guys competed here today, and 18 of them will go home eventually. And they'll be proud of everything they did. They made it all the way to the Olympic trials. They were in the conversation. And for even the ones that maybe didn't think that they had the best of shots, in my book, you got to finish. And each and every one of them did.
So there are hundreds and hundreds of numbers and totals. This is from the P&G Championships in Hartford, a two-day competition. The difference between Sam Mikulak and Chris Brooks, 1.65. Then Jake Dalton, 2.5. So there's three numbers to chew on for a little bit. And Akash Modi really had a good showing there, just missing the podium. Now when you combine those numbers with the numbers over these 2 days of the Olympic trials, we'll see what we get. Six ten to go. Here now is the combined total. Sam Mikulak, your runaway winner. Once again, Chris Brooks is second. We talked about how consistent he was. Then it's Jake Dalton. Then it's Danelle Wittenberg. Danelle Leyva in 10th. We'll take a break. When we come back, we'll have the announcement. In 5 minutes. At 40 seconds. What's going on in there?
Tomorrow night, the spotlight in St. Louis shifts back to the women as we take a giant step toward the Olympics by crowning the 2016 U.S. champion.
And there's your leader, Simone Biles.
She's the most dominant female athlete in the world today.
That might be the best one we've ever seen.
What a phenomenal first nationals on the road to Rio.
But right now, it's the moment of truth for the men. 18 dreams hang in the balance as the selection committee faces the difficult task of choosing the final five to represent the U.S. in Rio.
Being an Olympian, you're in a class of its own. Not a lot of people in the entire world can say they're an Olympian.
It's incredibly hard. You know, you look around and see all the guys that we have here, and it makes you honored to be a part of it, but it's scary to try and, you know, challenge all these other guys and fight for your spot.
I think that's what trials is about, is seeing who can handle the pressure that could be comparable to that of the Olympic Games.
And that was tremendous. Wow.
This is still the moment that I've always wanted my entire life, to make this Olympic team so that I can go on and be an Olympic champion.
That might be the biggest routine of the night.
We don't put in this many hours of work to not have the opportunity to go out there and compete for our country.
His Olympic journey might be getting a little bit closer.
I laid it all out there. I'm ready to go, and I can't wait to make it happen.
You make that mistake out there, it's the 30 seconds that they see.
Oh my goodness.
That can be detrimental to your selection chances.
Those type of things don't happen to Jake Dalton.
It's out of your hands now. You've done everything that you could possibly do, and then your dreams are in their hands.
I remember last time going to that room, I felt like I was gonna throw up. So nervous.
As we sit in that room, waiting for the selection committee to read off those names, everyone's just thinking, man, just get this over with.
These are minutes parents everywhere who are watching can empathize with. All you want their entire life is the best for your kids. Mikulik, Nodora's dad, all they want is the best for their kids. And in their mind, what's best for their kids is to be in Brazil in August. So the clock is continuing to count down. And Tim, when you take three guys who you think are right on the bubble and you take their scores and create an average, you do create a scenario where it literally is a difference of a tenth or two.
Yeah, it's crazy. It's crazy how close it is. But once again, I believe that Sam Mikulik is a lock. I believe that Alex Nador is a lock and Jake Dalton is a lock. And then you've got these three guys. You've got Danielle Leyva, you've got John Orozco, and you've got Chris Brooks. Chris Brooks, he's second in the all-around. He went 24 for 24. But let's take a look at the numbers. And what we're looking at here is the average of three. We're dropping each of the gymnast's lowest score on the key apparatus, which is pommel horse, parallel bars, and high bar. So Chris Brooks, you see the 14-0, the 14-5-2-5, and then John Orozco with the highest number. There's parallel bars. High bar is right there. And the total. And so if that's the only criteria that you're using, the team would be, in my opinion, Leyva and Orozco. But there's more to it than that, because you need to consider these athletes and what they historically have done. And the problem with that graph, in my opinion, if I were on the selection committee, I would say certainly John Orozco is in the hunt to make the Olympic team, but we cannot consider his pommel horse. I have seen him, you know, really struggle with that event. He's a great gymnast, but I would throw that out.
Okay, Nasi, you've been in a room, something like that. Are people talking? Is there nervous joking, or does it sound like church?
You know, I think it's definitely different for the men and the women. I remember in 2012 being in that situation. I knew in that moment I wasn't making the Olympic team, so it was a little more relaxed for me. But everyone's pretty tense because you just want to know. You just want to hear your name called, exactly as Alex Nador was saying. Just say my name, and that's really all you're hoping.
Well, we're told is that the selection committee has made up their minds. They've got the five guys, and they are in that sequestered room explaining their decision. This is them arriving to meet with the team and announce the five names, and oh, to be in that room for that. So Tim, round out your team. You mentioned the three. I'm not sure if you mentioned your last two.
I did not. I would definitely go with Chris Brooks and Danielle Leyva. And I have a lot of reasons for doing that. I think Chris Brooks, he earned his spot by being 24 for 24, the only of 18 athletes, I believe, that could even come close to saying that. And he's tremendous on parallel bars, high bar. He really helps the team. He can be there on vaulting if you need him. And Danielle Leyva, in my opinion, because he was injured prior to the PNG Championships in Hartford, I think that they should give him a little bit of slack. He could have petitioned directly to the Olympic trials. He chose not to. So he's got to live with those scores, but I think that should be factored in. He has won two world medals on parallel bars, and he is the most, at the last World Championships, a silver medal on high bar. That would be my team.
Imagine what it's going to feel like in 2 weeks in the women's story, a team that Nastia thinks could field three teams in the Olympic Games. That's for a different day. The parents are aching. They want to know, is my boy, is my husband, is he going or not? The crowd rhythmically chanting USA. Just about everyone has remained in their seats. It's time to find out who represents the United States in Rio.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the president and CEO of USA Gymnastics, Steve Penny.
Good evening. It's my pleasure to introduce the five members of the 2016 U.S. Olympic team for USA Gymnastics. Chris Brooks, Jake Dalton, Sam Mikulik, Alex Nador, and John Orozco!
And you know what I see most when I look at that team? I see two guys who waited 4 years and toiled in the gym, blood, sweat, tears. Alex Nador and Chris Brooks, who were alternates 4 years ago, finally capitalized and grabbed a piece of their dream.
And you can tell, I think, that John Orozco had feared the worst.
And you know, so what I believe they did is they looked, obviously, they considered John Orozco's pommel horse. I wouldn't have, but he's a tremendous gymnast and did a tremendous job.
What are you thinking right now?
I don't know why I'm so emotional, but just looking at their faces, especially seeing John Orozco in tears, the year that he has had with his mother passing away, it's just amazing.
Yeah. It's finally over, and that wasn't easy. This is John Orozco backstage. There had to be moments, sure there were, during these Olympic trials when they thought they were in. Certainly not now. Well, let's go to the flip side of that emotion. Let's go to Andrea Joyce.
Well, John Orozco has had more than his share of heartbreak over the last year and a half. But these tears of joy, can you possibly take us inside your head and tell us what's going through it right now?
I'm just at a loss for words, really. I just came to this competition and I really thought I had to stamp my toes and really show them that I can do this. And I just can't believe it. I can't put it into words. I'm just, after the past year and a half I've had and all the people that doubted me, I finally found the strength within myself to go out there and do it. And I know the job's not over, but I know that I can go out there now and really give it all I got. And I'm really proud of everyone that's helped me get to this point, especially my mom.
How much was your mom in your heart and in your mind tonight?
My mom was there the whole time, and I know she's looking down at me, and she's so proud. And if you can hear me, Mom, I love you.
Doctors told you last June that there was no way you would be able to compete for at least a year after that Achilles injury. What was it emotionally and physically that powered you through?
Just, I found it within myself, and the people who created that within myself are my family and my friends, and they just, their strength resonates with me so much, and I am so thankful. And the job's not over, and I know, and I'm proud to be representing USA, and I'm gonna give it all I got.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
We'll see you in Rio. How does that sound?
It's amazing.
Al.
Wow. Well, he's going to get a chance to redeem himself, because a lot of what went on in London is something he'd like to forget. Tomorrow night, it's the women's turn to determine their 2016 national champion. That'll be crowned right here in the same building. Coming up next, it's your local news. Later tonight, it's Saturday Night Live with host Matthew McConaughey and musical guest Adele. For Tim Daggett, Nastia Lukin, and Andrea Joyce, I'm Al Troutwig. Congratulations to those men. We'll see them again starting on August 5th, Rio de Janeiro.
This broadcast is presented by authority of the United States Olympic Committee and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form without the express written consent of the United States Olympic Committee.